week, the International Men's and Boys Wear Exhibition has been held in Olympia. As one of the exhibitors is top menswear designer Tom Gilbey, I went down to have a look. Tom Gilbey is a long-time supporter of the waistcoat and thinks it is the most important single item in any man's or woman's wardrobe. I asked him what's so special about it.
Well, first of all, it's economical. It hasn't got any sleeves, so that cuts costs to start with. On a more serious note, I think it can add a lot of humour. I mean, if you take people like Terry Thomas, and then you've got the cowboys wore them, which are very sexy, they're slung back and low. And I think they're marvellous for women. And of course, some men wear them very sophisticated and pompous. I mean, Churchill and Macmillan, they've all worn waistcoats in the past with their watch and chain. Great style, I love them.
Can you tell me about your designs and your own particular favourite?
Well, my own favourites is, I've gone back and I think the waistcoats are really, really English. They're nothing to do with the French for a change. And the Tattersall waistcoat, the country sort of waistcoat establishment, is marvellous. And as you notice, it's based on the traditional sort of hunting, riding, shooting waistcoat. Now, this is a new innovation, really, because this is the type of garment which looks marvellous on the beach and also is a sort of handbag for men. And it's great to going for the beach bar. It's marvellous on women, of course, the nudist beach. Ah, this is my sort of piece of resistance. It's the Noel Coward sort of Terry Thomas type look, bringing the fancy waistcoats with lots of colour into evening. And what I've done here, instead of the traditional smoking jacket with a glass of port, I've turned it into a waistcoat. And the same thing for the girl. I mean, the girl is very, very big all round. You have all these variations with waistcoats. And then, you know, the type of waistcoat I'm wearing. I mean, this is a pure functional waistcoat.
Can you tell me about that, then?
Well,
what do you call it?
Well, I call this my commuter motorist waistcoat, but it's equally as good for a cyclist. It's got all these pockets, which seem a joke, but they are serious. I've got the RAC or the AA badge here. I've got my breakdown kit on the back if I'm stuck in the road. And it's a marvellous functional garment that if you're carrying little tape recorders, hi-fi, the businessman travelling on the train, I think in the future we'll carry all these little hi-fi microphones that one's having, but they're disguised, and he's learning languages on the way to work. He actually uses this as an office, which I think is, rather than his briefcase, which I think is detached.
You were the man that actually told us we'd all be walking around in tracksuits. So what do you think the waistcoat's going to do for us in the 80s?
Oh, I definitely think that children, men, women, everybody's going to be wearing them, even the pregnant woman out here, because you buy a basic smock in one colour, you have all your little waistcoat, your peasant look and waistcoat, and it actually grows out with you, see? And then when you produce the brat, it comes back and you can wear it. It fits everybody. And I think the waistcoat is going to do for the 80s what the T-shirt has done since the 60s.